Hello, everyone. We are the Nobodies. What are we doing here today?
Today, we are going to go back in time when Mosh was called something different.
You like these back in time videos, don't you?
Yes. The name of the band is Exodus. And I bet you even before I say it, all you old timers know exactly what I'm about to say. The Toxic Waltz.
Nice.
This song, I think, came out in the 89? I'm going to go with 89. All right. Not 91.
And tell us down in the comment section below if he's wrong. All right. So, without further ado, because I don't know much about the song, I'm Son.
And I'm Father.
Let's do this. So I'm not sure, but they seem very energetic.
Yes. This was one of the bands that were big time in the thrash scene. They were speed metal thrash.
I know I've heard of Exodus before, but I don't know if we've listened to any...
Not on this channel.
We've not listened to any Exodus on this channel.
You know, you've definitely probably heard it in my car or you know, watching a video or YouTube or whatever. But this is... a theme song for moshing, you know. You could hear it. Just listen to the lyrics, you know. It was our theme song growing up. You know, as cheesy as it sounds, as cheesy as the video looks, you know, it's like. But like when you're 16, you're like, yeah, Toxic Waltz, and then that now you could listen back and go, it's kind of cheesy, you know. Being the age I am today,
understandable. I haven't gotten those vibes yet.
Because you're my age when I started listening to it, so right now it should be really cool to you.
I hope so.
I'm gonna hit your head on the wall. Yeah.
The chorus was a little cheesy there.
If you don't, you will fall. Yeah.
Everybody's doing the Toxic Waltz. Yeah. But other than that, it's been fine.
I love it.
You
this
love
is,
it?
Yo, let me tell you something. When you're in the freaking pit at an Exodus show, when you're 16 years old, when this song came on,
that's probably
it was just circle of just people kicking the crap out of each other. Definitely, damn. you could feel that vibe. You know, like I said, back then it's like a theme song. Like your parents are like, you know, clean your room, do your homework. You're like, no, yeah, I'm doing the Toxic Waltz. Go screw yourself.
I've been in one mosh pit my whole life.
Yes, Testament and Sepultura.
That was an experience. It was around the time, here, story time. I had braces at the time. So, you know, there was this one guy, he was, like, really into it. And, you know, he looked like he listened to heavy metal. Had the freaking mohawk and everything. Freaking there he was, head forward. There I was. My mouth was a little bit open trying to breathe.
Wow.
Forehead and my braces.
Nice.
Right there. I remember that so vividly. And I couldn't apologize. No. It's like, who's the guy?
Because I'm in the middle of a mosh pit.
I'm in the middle of a mosh pit. But I remember that one specific guy I slammed my braces into.
Nice.
He was short, too. Oh, wait. Ooh, that is a chorus.
Everybody's doing the toxic waltz.
Like,
it's kind of cheesy.
It's kind of cheesy.
Yeah. It's all right. Look, the video's cheesy, you know? But you gotta admit, the guitar riffs are freaking hot, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're on fire right now. It's freaking speed thrash at its finest. The drummer, he's great. He's, you know, he's doing his roles. It's beautiful. The music is amazing, but, you know, his lyrics are, you know, that I guess, what were they, 22 back then? 25 at the most?
They were an aspiring heavy metal.
Yeah, they were burned out, you know, on drugs and probably in drinking. And they're like, yo, kick your head in the friend. We're going to have a ball. Yeah, throw it in, man. Yeah. What can we use as the next verse? There are a lot of faces. I'm going to hit them in my head with my braces. Yeah, throw it in there. You know what I mean? That's how the lyrics were freaking written.
Yeah, the one thing I noticed right before the chorus is I was like, with us, Exodus.
Yeah, that's so cheesy. You know, that's as cheesy as you get.
That's very cheesy.
You know, even in rap, I can't stand when freaking all the rappers, they sit there and they put their name in it. And like, you know, they got to name their name 20 times. Or they got to name the producer who put down the beats. You know what I mean?
Two chain.
Right? Yeah, stop right there. Stop right there. You gotta admit, that solo was
That was one hell of a solo.
The best thing about that solo was it fit the song.
Yeah.
It wasn't over the top, it wasn't under, it wasn't enough, you know, it wasn't not enough, it wasn't too much.
That was the part where they start punching the shit out of each other.
Yeah, it was like they were telling a story, and it actually, like, it fit, and then the next guy would go, like, they were just telling a story, that, you know, back and forth. They were doing, like, a guitar battle.
Yeah.
I don't know if you know, but the guitarist that was wearing the one with the words, I'm not sure of his name, but he is actually the guitarist of Slayer for the past couple years.
Really?
Yes.
Like, wait, the past couple years, like, back then?
Like,
or the past 10, couple years?
10 years ago? No, I'm saying Slayer just finished forever. They retired.
Yeah.
They just did their final tour, I think, like, this for the third time.
And for the past few years, that guitarist was...
He was Slayer's guitarist.
Huh.
Yeah.
Nice.
Fun fact.
I've got a question, though.
Yeah.
I've seen, like, three guys stage dive now.
Yeah, no, when
How
you're
they
in...
get back on stage?
when you're in a small, small venue like that, back in those days, it was impossible for the security guards to stop anybody. Because back then, moshing was the thing. The kids were crazy. And your goal was to get up on stage and stage dive.
So is it people? It's members, not them.
No, it's the crowd.
Huh.
Yeah, it's the crowd. They used to beat through the security guards, jump on stage, run around, and as the guitarists were playing, they were knocking you back onto the crowd. And if you got hit by the guitarist in the face by a guitar, that was like, yeah! And he'd come back and do it again.
Yeah!
But a lot of people, you know how I pick you up and you crowd surf across the whole crowd?
I have crowd surfed 3 times in my life.
Yes. Well, they jump off the stage into a crowd surf.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's the opposite way. We brought you from the back to the front, and then the security guard grabs you and lets you back in. They used to run through, jump on the stage, jump into the crowd, and head out to the back door.
Nice.
Totally different animal these days. Everyone, you know, kids were crazy back then. Nuts.
No offense, but most of the heavy metal fans nowadays are in their 40s.
Yes.
Corny song.
Shut up!
Whoa, wait, no, Ed, stop. Okay, there we go. The Master's on YouTube TV. Check it out right now. We're not sponsored. I mean, it was good. It was really corny. I don't know what to tell you, man. I see your point.
Back then, it wasn't corny. Back then, it was best thing ever to come out. People were like, oh my god, you had a new Exodus song, and everyone's like, yeah, we're gonna blah. Now then I look back as years went on and I'm like, wow, that was kind of corny.
Nice. Although guitar player killed it. This was his
they
song.
Both did they,
yeah, yeah, both guitarists killed the song.
Yeah, everybody killed it. It was a great song with the lyrics were, that's what made it cheesy. If there was no lyrics, that was some sick riffs, sick drumming. You know, groovy. You could get into it. You could headbang. It was like, it was rocking and rolling from beginning to end.
Yeah, yeah.
But then the second he comes in, it was like a third grader. All right, kids, go ahead and write a poem. Yeah, and he probably got a B+.
All right, yeah, that's about right. All right, so, I'm gonna like, comment, and subscribe. Tell us down in the comment section below what songs we should listen to, because we take your requests. And press the subscribe button with the little bell next to it to get notified every time we upload a video.
Yes.
And buy some shirts. We got some shirts in constructions on.
No, it's not in construction. It's not. It's up and ready to go.
It's up and running on cafepress.com/thenobodies.
Yes. Brand new logo shirts.
Freaking, without sounding like an advertiser, I think these are the nicest shirts we got to date. Nicest shirts we've got to date. Please go check them out. Buy some shirts because I think you'll really appreciate it as a nobody's
fan. And we would appreciate it.
And we would appreciate it too. We
as a nobody's.
I'm son.
And I'm father.
Rock on.